In this video, we'll show how to assemble a Tofflemire. Assemble the appropriate armamentarium. Select the appropriate size and shape of band. Select an appropriately sized wedge as well. Fold the matrix loop such that you bring the two ends of the matrix band together. Orient the band such that the smaller opening is facing the gingiva. The larger circumference opening is the occlusal portion. Optionally, you may also round the loop of the matrix using a round or cylindrical hand instrument. This illustration shows the different components of a Tofflemire retainer. On the left, you'll see the head with the guide channel, the vise with the diagonal slot, which receives the band, the rotating spindle, the adjusting nut, which changes the size of the loop, and the locking nut, which keeps the band in place. Hold the retainer so that the slot on the head faces upward. Slip the two ends of the looped matrix through the diagonal slot on the vise of the retainer. Depending on the quadrant, the loop will come out of the right or left side of the diagonal slots on the vise. If working on the upper right or lower left quadrant, the loop will come out of the slots located on the right side. If working on the lower right or upper left quadrant, the loop will come out on the left. Again, left and right are in relation to the diagonal slots on the vise. Remember to flip over the Tofflemire so that the U-shaped slot is facing toward the gingiva. Secure the band in place by turning the locking nut in a clockwise direction. This will prevent the band from slipping out of the retainer. You may also pre-wedge to further open the contact. Orient the retainer such that the open end of the retainer faces towards the gingiva. Place the loop over the crown of the tooth being restored. The retainer should rest adjacent to the buckle. It should not be placed lingually or rest on any teeth. Remove the pre-wedge as applicable. Adjust the diameter of the matrix loop around the sides of the tooth by turning the adjusting nut in a clockwise direction. Place the wedge to create an embrasure and secure the matrix. Optionally, you may also add a wedge in from the buckle in addition to the lingual for larger embrasures. Finally, burnish the contact area using a hand instrument. Then, inspect the matrix setup to ensure that all edges are sealed around the tooth. Thanks for learning with us!